Hello friends. The idea for this video came up spontaneously during my mental amusements when I was adding another function to my Home Assistant smart home system. The task was simple. With the beginning of the school year, my daughter needed an alarm clock, one not connected to her smartphone. So, I decided to make it based on an already existing Google Nest smart speaker, but using Home Assistant logic. While writing the logic, new ideas came to me on how it could be improved. As a result, I ended up with quite an interesting solution, which may be useful for someone else, either as a whole or in the form of individual solutions. More details in my video, but for now, as always, I kindly ask you to give a like. This will help other people interested in the topic of smart homes to find it. And of course, subscribe to my channel if you haven't done so already. Let's look right away at the result, and then I'll show the implementation. So, I have three alarms. Each of them has its own activity switch. If it's turned on, as with alarm 1, it works. If it's turned off, like with alarms 2 and 3, it doesn't work. For each of these alarms, I added its own working period selector. I made two options. A single activation, after which the activity switch is automatically turned off. On working days, from Monday to Friday, excluding Saturday and Sunday. If needed, more such options can be added. The next parameter for each alarm is the activation time. It is set in this field. I made it possible for each alarm to choose from several melodies, in my case 5. These are physical MP3 files located on the Home Assistant server itself. There are no limits on the number. You can add as many as you need. Another point, the melody plays with increasing volume. It starts quietly and gradually becomes louder until the very end. This is how the alarm triggering looks. It starts at a low volume and gradually increases up to the end of the ring. Now let's move on to the implementation. As alarm melodies, I decided to use local MP3 files so as not to depend on internet access. For uploading, the media section is used. There is a folder called My Media. I uploaded 5 melodies and specifically renamed them in a unified format. Melody 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. This is needed for the convenience of implementing the package logic. More on that a bit later. Here you can either upload new media files, or, if necessary, delete old ones that are no longer needed. For generating such melodies, I use the Suno neural network. This allows me to create exactly the options I like, without the need to search for ready-made files online. Everything is implemented simply and intuitively. Now let's move directly to the package. As always, you can find the text file at the link in the description under this video. And now I will explain in detail the purpose of each block of this package. These are 3 input Boolean objects, logical switches used to activate each of the alarms. In my case, there are 3. Next come 3 date and time input objects, one for each alarm. The ability to input a date is disabled here, since alarms don't need it. Only time input is available. Next comes the block of selectors. This is a drop-down menu with the ability to choose. These 3 selectors define the operating mode of the alarm. I made 2 options, single activation and activation by weekdays, from Monday to Friday, without Saturday and Sunday. And these 3 selectors allow you to set a melody for each of the alarms. As options, I use names identical to the file names, only without the .mp3 extension. The default value is melody1. That is precisely why the files in the media folder I showed earlier all have standardized names. And, of course, in this package I couldn't do without my favorite template sensors. Here I use binary sensors to determine the triggering of each alarm, taking into account its type, single or periodic on working weekdays. This is the template for the single activation of the first alarm. For the second and third, it has exactly the same logic, differing only in the names of the sensor itself and of the objects used, selectors, and the time input field. For it to work, two conditions must be met. The first, the state of the selector of the corresponding alarm must be single activation. The second condition, the current time sensor must match the time set in the time input field of the corresponding alarm. The sensor for periodic activation is a bit more complex. In addition to the weekday's value in the corresponding selector and the match of the current time with the time in the input field, there is one more condition. It must be a day from Monday to Friday. These sensors are identical for each alarm, except for the logical object numbers. Now let's move on to the script. I didn't create a separate script for each alarm, I made one. To be able to pass different parameters to it, I used variables. Let's figure it out. This is the variable block. Here names and values are set. Later in the script, only the names are used, and their values are taken either from this block or passed to the script externally. The first variable, player. It contains the name of the media player object that will receive the command to play melodies. To replace the device, it's enough to change the name only here, and that's it. The next variable, default media. This is the path to the default media file that will be used in the alarms. Next come the values for implementing smooth volume increase. Starting volume, 0.2, that is, 20%. Increase step, 5%. Number of steps, 5. Next begins the body of the script itself. The first block is setting the starting volume. The media player volume set service is used. As the target, the device specified in the player variable is taken, and the volume level is set with the start variable value. The next block, starting the playback of melodies. Here the name of the object from the player variable is also used, and the value of the media variable is passed as the media file. This variable is not specified in our block, it can be passed externally. If it is not set, the value from the default media variable specified in the variable block is used. The media content type is music. To implement smooth volume increase, a repeat block is used. The number of steps is taken from the steps variable, which was set in the initial block, in this example, 5 steps. Then execution begins. Every 10 seconds, through the volume setting service, the object whose name is specified in the player variable receives a new volume value. It is calculated by the formula, starting volume plus the level specified in the step variable, in this case 5%, multiplied by the repeat number. For example, on the third repeat it will be starting volume plus 15%. And after executing the repeat block, that is 5 steps, the last 10-second delay starts, after which the melody playback stops. Thus, 5 steps of 10 seconds plus the final delay add up to 1 minute of alarm sound. Now let's move on to automation. I also made just one, like the script, so it has many triggers that launch actions. The actions themselves are executed using a condition selector. Let's go into the details. These three triggers are intended for the single activation of each of the three alarms. Each trigger has its own ID, by which the condition selector then determines which action to perform. Similarly, a block of three triggers for periodic activation on working weekdays for each of the three alarms. In total, there are 6 triggers, matching the number of previously created template sensors. The action block for automation is implemented using a condition selector. It determines by ID which trigger has fired and performs the corresponding actions. The condition blocks are implemented the same way for all actions. The first condition, determination by ID, which trigger has fired. The second, checking whether the input Boolean corresponding to this alarm is turned on, which determines if it is active or not. The actions in each block begin with starting the script. This is common for the whole automation. When starting, the script name is specified and the media variable is passed, which contains the path to the media file. This path is formed from the static part and the value of the melody selector of the corresponding alarm, with the addition of the .mp3 extension. This is the file name I showed at the beginning, and that is why all files have standardized names. In the actions corresponding to the single activation triggers, the service of turning off the corresponding input Boolean is additionally launched, so that the alarm will not trigger again. The selector block, which works for the periodic mode, is arranged in the same way. The only difference is, it does not turn off the activity input Boolean, and the alarm continues to trigger on other days. Let's once again look at how the alarm parameters are set, and then how it is triggered. I remind you, in this example, the alarm melody plays for 1 minute. The logic shown here can be used not only for implementing alarms, but also for any other scenarios, notifications, reminders, event alerts, and so on. That's all. I hope the video was interesting and useful for you. I will be grateful for your likes. They help with promotion on YouTube, and if you don't want to miss new videos, subscribe to my channel. In the description under the video, I will leave links to all the mentioned resources, as well as to my Telegram channels and social networks, groups for communication about smart home topics. Join in, it will be interesting. Thank you for your attention. See you next time. Peace to all.